Right,
high energy. Mm-hmm. Let's finish this one strong.
High energy. Let's finish it. Let's finish it strong, strong, strong.
And
strong.
3, 2, 1.
Welcome back to Makings by Chanel Dijon. So today, got a little fancy with y'all. I am actually gonna make a full course meal, which are three things. I don't know if that's considered a full course meal or not. But we are making today garlic asparagus, salmon, and garlic mash. Seriously. I make sure look easy, but they don't know what it takes. Don't ask me the time, I got baguettes in the face. Rojo drops on Louis, I want everything he made. When it comes to hoes, I never be the one to save. This is the meal that you make when you are trying to make your man, okay? This is that meal. This will turn him from boyfriend to fiance. I don't have my ring on, but fiance, okay? Let's get cooking. So we've already done our mashed potatoes. What I did was I peeled the mashed potatoes already, and I diced them in little squares so they are ready to go in the pot with water, ready to boil and cook while we get started on everything else. Preheat your oven, did not do that, I'm gonna do it now. So we're gonna preheat our oven to about, let's say 375. Let's preheat that oven to 375. Let's get the, let's get those potatoes on the stove and let's get cooking. Okay, so let's fill your pot up with water. Then we're gonna put the potatoes in the water, add a little bit of salt. Gonna put it on the stove and let it do its thing. And we're gonna get ready for everything else. So we're gonna just, probably you should have just, probably it would have been smarter to put the potatoes in there and then fill it up with water so you don't get that splashback. But I'm gonna just go ahead and we gonna wang with it. Y'all remember that song? Wang with it. Okay, yeah, so go ahead and put it on the skillet. This will be the only time I tell you where salt actually does matter. Go ahead and sprinkle a little bit of salt into your potato water. Just a little shake, shake. It never hurt nobody. And let's put that fire on high, medium high. Medium high so we can get to cooking. Today's wine is, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing it right, but Ida Zinfandel, years 2000. So, yum. Let's see how this is tasting. Not really a Zinfandel type of gal, but that'll do. That will do. Okay, let's season this salmon and get it going. Sprinkle just a little bit of that olive oil on each piece. Not a lot, just a little bit. We wanna just get it, you know, just a little slippery. Just a little slip. You know, get it moisturized. We wanna moisturize the salmon, y'all. So you moisturize your salmon, rub it all in. Mm-hmm. There we go. Rub it all in. Cool. Okay. And now that you've rubbed your olive oil in on your salmon, you're gonna get to actually seasoning it. But before you start to season, this is what I want you guys to do. I want you to turn your pan on medium, okay? And drop that garlic butter in there because that is exactly what we are using today. We are using the garlic butter, my favorite. You guys all know that this is my favorite. I love Kerrygold garlic butter. I don't know what it is. It's like gold, literally, for me. But I love it. So we're gonna go ahead and drop that into the pan while we get ready to do this salmon, okay? Okay. Salt and pepper. Just a little bit. Remember, this is the basics. Listen. If you think you can't cook, if you got salt and pepper, you can do a little something, okay? You can get by, all right? Y'all know that that's my favorite, the little salt and pepper. Light work, because we're gonna use lemon pepper. So it's just really light on the little pepper. Really light, okay, guys? Also, I wanna let y'all know, I left my skin on my salmon, okay? See? A lot of you guys may be grossed out, I'm so sorry. I personally like the skin on my salmon. Okay, let's go. Pike's fish, go ahead, sprinkle that onto the salmon. Be careful with it because it can get spicy. So we're gonna just sprinkle that. But you could be a little heavy on it, but like I said, it can get spicy. It will add a kick of flavor, okay? My fave. There we go. See how I just sprinkle that onto the pan? Because also, don't think when you do it in a pan like this, don't think like, oh my God, I'm wasting all the seasonings. No, you're not. Because what you're gonna do is you're gonna take that salmon and you're gonna wipe it all up with all the seasonings, okay? Because we're gonna get all our money's worth, all right, y'all? That's what I'm talking about. We're gonna get all our little money's worth on this salmon, all right? Now you hear the garlic butter sizzling behind me. Let's move that garlic butter around. We don't want it to burn in one place. So let's just kind of move it around. Oh yeah, it's fully melting. That's what I'm talking about. All right, last but not least, lemon pepper. Which I could do for some lemon pepper wings. So bad. I've been craving lemon pepper wings, but because of course I don't eat chicken because I'm pescatarian, I have not been having any. But man, have I been craving it. All right, so a little bit of lemon pepper in here. Wow, that was a lot. Tends to happen. Lemon. Cut your lemon, but save it. Okay, guys? Save it. Make sure you save it. Okay? Cut your lemon. Make sure. We're gonna do this after, once it gets in the boiler. Well, not once it gets in the pan. Are you ready? We're gonna transfer this salmon into the pan because it's ready to go. All right, so with our salmon, like I said, we're gonna get all the little money's worth. So we're gonna take this salmon right here. In the bottom of it, since we did not season it, or if you don't like the skin, completely understand, a lot of people don't. But if you do, take the bottom of that, wipe the bottom of the pan, okay? Because we want to get that seasoned too. We want to get literally all of that seasoned, okay? So wipe it in, go ahead and lay it in that garlic butter. I said we are cooking salmon. I never said healthy salmon. I said salmon though, okay? Same thing with each one. Go ahead and wipe the pan with that. Let's get all our money's worth on that seasoning, okay? No seasoning left behind. Go ahead and lay it in that pan. Oh my goodness. That's gonna be amazing. See, no seasoning left behind. Look at that. All right, and then let's put that one in here. Okay, so we're gonna let that sort of cook and marinate in the garlic butter. You guys are gonna get tired of this hair. All right, so while our, look at that. First of all, look at your salmon cooking. Wow. If that already does not tell you that this is gonna get ready to be an amazing meal, it should. I actually got this pan from Williams and Sonoma. I love this pan for this meal because I can transfer it from the skillet. Well, not from the skillet, I'm sorry. I can transfer it from the stove into the oven without removing it from the skillet. So I absolutely love this pan. It's made by La Crust. And it just kind of sort of just cooks your food really even and really marinating that food and that butter, especially when you use it. The skillet doesn't get that hot when you have it on medium. So I love it. If you could see, hold on 1 second. Let me see if I could show you guys. I'll use one of these for grilling. But see how the size of the salmon is already cooking? Look at that. See, it's already roasting in that skillet. And then look at the bottom. Look how juicy it is. It's already coming off of the skin. I love it. So we're gonna let that marinate on there for about like another, I'm gonna say another 3 minutes, and then we're gonna flip it. Okay, so now we're gonna want to flip all of our pieces of salmon because it is juicy at the bottom. Watch this. Oh my God. That is how you want your skin of your salmon to be. Nice and crispy and flavorful. Oh my goodness, you guys. This is gonna be amazing. So let's go ahead and flip this salmon. Ah! Am I the only person that gets excited about food? Because god damn. Damn, darn it. Look at that. Already coming off of the skin. You guys, I'm telling you, cook this for your man if you want to get married, girl. This is it. Look at that. Look at how it's peeling on the side because it's so good and so juicy and tender, okay? All right, so we're going to let this cook on the top for a while because we want to get that real nice crust on the top. So this is how all of your salmon should look. Oh my goodness. Y'all, I'm excited. This is gonna be a fire meal. Your potatoes should be doing just this. So I'm gonna just let that still cook for a while the top of my salmon is cooking. And then I can prep my asparagus. I already know y'all gonna call me wasteful, but my kids do not like the ends of the asparagus and neither do I. So we just simply chop those off, okay? Chop them off, it's all right, I promise. So go ahead and just chop the ends of the asparagus. I'm not sure if you're supposed to be doing this anyway. You could be, like I said, y'all know my warning, I am not a chef. Never have been, but maybe you were supposed to do that. I'm not sure, but I'm doing it because my kids don't like it and neither do I. So with the inch chop, you're gonna wanna take your asparagus, spread it out like this, get a pan. I do my asparagus last, you guys, when my food is about to be ready, just because, I don't know, I like my vegetables hot. So have it prepped, cut out the sides, set it aside. Okay, so our salmon is looking amazing, okay? I'm so excited for you guys' meal. I'm so excited for you guys' comments to see how you guys like this meal, because actually I think this is like the first time of me doing like a full course meal with you guys. So we moving up in the world, okay? It's no more just one dishes, it's like a full course. All right, so this video may be a little bit longer, but it's gonna be good. So now that that's just kind of marinated in the garlic butter, we're gonna wanna flip it over to check it. Let's see if it's ready first to be, and I'm gonna tell you guys how to tell. Oh yeah, that's ready. That's ready, you see how that looks? That looks like it's ready to be eaten, but it's not. I promise you, if you bite into it, it's still raw. And I don't like my stuff. Uh-oh, I don't like, be careful, cause your salmon is gonna be like, be careful, cause you don't wanna do that. We are gonna take it straight off the skillet. See, now this is one thing I do wanna show you guys. Come here. I wanna show you guys this. This is why we are putting it in the oven. You see how it's still raw in the inside? So we already have it crusted at the bottom and at the top now, and we already have those flavors in there. Now we're gonna put it in the oven so it can really cook thoroughly through. So we're gonna put it in the oven for about maybe, I wanna say probably like 20 minutes will be good. All right, and let's put in the oven. All right, for about, let's say, I think a good 20 minutes will be good. All right, so midway into your salmon cooking in the oven, you're gonna want to pull it out and just sort of add some lemon to that, each one. And that's just gonna bring your flavor to a whole another level. Oh my goodness. Yum, I'm so excited. It's gonna taste so good. You're going to want to take a handy dandy fork. And you're gonna wanna just push it up against the pot. Once it crumbles with a little bit of pressure, that means they're ready. All right, you guys. First things first, a spoon full of, y'all saw that save, that was nice. A spoon full of butter. Oh, if it isn't the Fortnite King. I don't know if anybody else, actually I do know, because I've seen a lot of moms message me and say that their kids have been addicted to Fortnite. I don't ever see mine. My kid just kind of sort of stays in his room. Okay, back to our mashed potatoes. That's probably what made him come out, was the salmon and the mashed potatoes. That was the smell of it, probably made him, drug him out of his room. So if you want to get your kid off of Fortnite, cook these mashed potatoes and salmon. All right, kind of just roll around the butter, kind of mix it. Also remember, like I said, your heat should be on very low because we still want to cut and cook those mashed potatoes so our job could be a little bit easier. Gonna put that on there. And let's get to really mashing. Mash. You're gonna wanna take another stick of butter. Well, not another stick, but another handful of butter. Put that in there, okay? Mix that in there. Go ahead and just let that melt. We're gonna add our milk. All right. I've always wondered what oat milk would do, because Kylan is lactose intolerant, and he said the oat milk tastes like regular milk. I've always wondered, like, how does that work with cooking purposes? I'm not gonna try it, but one day I will, and I'll let y'all know.
Oat is so good.
Oat milk is so good.
It's so good.
Oh, but the brand is a specific brand.
The orange and white one, right?
No, the gray and white one. So good. I'll let you taste them. Okay, so now we're gonna put a little bit of milk in there. You know, y'all know I don't use measurements, but I must just say like maybe like a cup, maybe a little bit more. I don't know what that was. I'm so sorry, y'all. I don't know what that was, but y'all measure it and let me know. It maybe comes out to be like a cup, maybe possibly, I'm thinking. Mix that in there. I literally just do the milk and butter until I get the right consistency that I want. See, like this consistency right now, it ain't working for me. So I know that I need to repeat the process of a little bit of butter, of more butter and more milk. Oh my goodness. Okay. That salmon.
Oh my God.
That salmon is amazing, okay? All right, let's get back to our mashed potatoes. Now that our salmon is done, it's still kind of cooking on the skillet. I kind of want these just a little bit more creamier, so I'm gonna add just a tad bit. Milk. Ooh, that was a lot, but I think God got me. He gonna make it work. He knows what I need, right? He knows the consistency. Look at that. And it was the perfect consistency right there. Now, all we're gonna do is salt our potatoes. Key, black pepper. Go a little heavy, because we kinda like a little heavy. And then garlic salt. That is it. That's it. That's all you need, y'all. Taste it though to make sure that it is seasoned to your preference and what you want. You may decide, like, I don't want garlic mashed potatoes. And that's completely fine. Make regular mashed potatoes. Just use salt. Do everything that I did. Just use salt and pepper. I love to use my asparagus in this pan specifically because it has the, like, I don't know, grooves. It's actually a baking pan, but I like to use it as a spare. I like to use it for my veggies too. Yeah, let's take a sip of our wine. And let's add drizzle. And then also go ahead and remove your salmon from your, go ahead and remove your salmon from your skillet, because like I said before in a lot of my videos, when you turn your skillet off, your food still cooks. And I don't want that for this. I don't want the salmon to be burnt. Now, this is key. I'm glad that this salmon did this. You see how cooked through? It's literally cooked to perfection. That flakiness on that salmon, it's not raw, it's not overcooked, it's cooked to perfection. It still has the juice of the salmon left in it. It's literally perfect. I know Kyle is like dying to taste a piece of the salmon. Should we let him? Should we just give him like a piece of the salmon? I think like maybe just a
audience POV.
Right. I think maybe just like a piece. Grab like that piece of salmon.
Oh my God. Oh my God, he's alive. He's alive.
I think if it was any video,
I think
if it was any video that Kyle ever believed in me in, I think it is probably this one. Like, okay, so you gotta take your asparagus, put it in the pan, right? Go ahead and, this is why I like this pan, go ahead and just roll your asparagus in that olive oil right there. Get it hot, get it juicy, get it wet, okay? But not out the pan. Let's leave it in the pan because y'all didn't see that, okay? Now that your asparagus is sizzling, go ahead and sprinkle that garlic salt on your asparagus. Okay, roll it around. I'm sure real chefs don't call this rolling it around. I'm sure there's a name, maybe sauteing it. Maybe they'll say. So saute your asparagus. But what I like to do is where's my heat? I like to keep it on this, but I like to actually add a top to the skillet. This top doesn't fit this skillet, but what it does is that you'll actually kind of like half-ass grill and steam the salmon all at the same time, and that's what I need because I don't like my salmon too hard and I don't like it too chewy. So when I put the top on top of it, on the skillet, it cooks it just right. You're almost done, so get your plate ready, okay? Kai, you eat it?
Jeez.
You hear him? I'm hungry. That's why I be cooking so sweet. I gotta taste your food so you don't die. To make sure that, you know, nobody put nothing in it. That's kind of crazy. Oh my God. I don't know. At this point, I think you need to pay me some type of money for this. Here, baby.
Thank you.
You're welcome, sweetie. Your mom's got that at Amazon.
You know what, Kyle?
Add a little lemon to your asparagus if you want to get fancy like me. You see that? Ooh. I oughta work at Benihana's. I oughta own Benihana's. That's more like it, right? I just want to tell you guys, I appreciate you guys watching my shows. I appreciate you guys tuning in to the makings of Chanel. The way this asparagus is finna hit, y'all are finna be even more addicted to watching these videos because it's that good. Ready. Kyle, are you ready to taste this?
I've never been so ready in my life.
It is ready for you to taste. I'll take it. Come and taste. Our grilled asparagus, garlic mashed with our amazing, I don't know what, lemon garlic salmon.
Woo! You know, my favorite part is this part, the skinny little part.
Oh, is it? I like that part too.
I think it's the salmon belly, but I don't know.
Ew.
I'm just gonna sound it.
Is it? While you're doing that, I'm probably gonna make. Did you see
that? He just went.
I waited my whole life for this moment.
Yes.
That's really good, guys. If it doesn't taste good, it's probably your fault.
Yeah, no, seriously. I'm telling y'all. That mashed potato, though.
How'd you get the skin like that?
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. The skin, I'm telling y'all, if y'all don't like skin, y'all really need to try it the way that I do it because that skin hits on another level, okay?
Dude.
I know, the asparagus is fire.
It's not healthy, but yeah.
It's not healthy at all. This is not your healthy asparagus, okay? This is not your health. I cook absolutely nothing healthy. Absolutely. But I cook food to feed your soul.
You do cook vegetables sometimes.
Yeah, I do cook vegetables, but not the healthy way. But I cook food to feed your soul. So it's I cook comfort food. So, yeah, hopefully.
This is so good.
Yeah.
This is probably the best salmon I've ever had in my life. This is better than my salmon, and I make the best salmon. Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. I hope you guys loved my meal. I hope you guys love this asparagus. I hope you guys love the mashed potatoes, the salmon, all of that. Like, don't forget to like. Please don't forget to comment. Let me know how you guys liked it. Let me know what else you guys wanna see. This will go so good with my macaroni and cheese recipe. So if you want, go ahead and add that because listen, if you're really trying to get your man to marry you, add that macaroni and cheese, okay? That is fire. But go ahead, like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you so much for coming back to Makings by Chanel Dijon. Bye.
It was so good. Best episode.
Yeah, guys. Y'all are making me smile, y'all.